Set to go now on a beautiful sunny afternoon. And here we go. We're underway in Madden Ultimate Team. And we'll see a return here from the end zone. And the decision to bring it out, not a good one, as he's tackled at the 15.
For most people, the excitement of a kickoff return is to see a long one that goes back in the opposite direction. But for the guys covering it, it's being able to stop them deep in their own territory. How about that incredible form tackle right there? Shoulder into ball carrier, and down he goes.
On first down, Lance. Screenplay, Johnson. The game's first play produces 6 yards, brings up second down.
So Charles, first drive here, a little safe completion underneath, maybe get some rhythm, get your feet wet, so to speak.
I agree, and I like it because it's a lot like a basketball game when you're getting started and you pass the ball around so everyone touches it early and gets involved in the game. In this case, it's not just dumping it to a back and he's able to run with the ball, but you get your offensive linemen involved because they get to get out and run and hit people in the open field. Everyone getting their feet wet early.
Well, that'll be incomplete. He took a shot as he let that go. And it's going to bring up a third down.
Well, the great coach has said football is really a simple game. Rush theirs, protect yours. And he's talking about those guys throwing the football. In this situation, the rush won, hitting the quarterback and forcing him into an incompletion.
And they'll look to avoid an early three and out here on 3rd and 4. And Lance now to throw. Into a double team and it's intercepted. Picked off by the 13-time Pro Bowler Ray Lewis. And he is going to get this one back to the 20-yard line.
That's kind of a double whammy. I mean, the interception on the opening drive, that's one thing. But to give him this field position, that's another.
Absolutely perfect start for this defense. They take the ball away on the opening possession. They know that their offense will get the ball to start the second half. They line them up in field goal position. And to me, they got a chance for a touchdown right here out of the gate.
First down, Vic. Throwing the out route and complete. It's Brown. 7 yards, the pick up there. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain that time as it's going to leave him with a 3rd and about 3 to go. Here's Vic. He'll dump this to Ball. It's complete. And the Eagles are going to have 1st and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points. Big completion there on 3rd and short. Keeps their opening drive alive.
Not only alive, but plenty of possibilities now. 1st and goal, and you know me, I'm a big advocate. If you're going to throw the ball, throw it early in the down and distance count.
They'll try and run for it on 1st and goal. And he'll be stopped about a yard shy of the goal line after a pickup of about 3.
And Brad, they went to a nickel defense, and that's a surprise this close to the goal line, because ordinarily you use the back end of the end zone, the sidelines, as extra defenders, and you want bigger people on the field to try and help against the run.
2nd and goal from the 1. Now a toss out to Earl Campbell. And this one will wind up with him losing yardage back to the 4-yard line. This will be a loss of 3, and now a much tougher 3rd down looming. From the shotgun, it's Vic being chased out left. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
Well, he certainly did a nice job improvising there, extending the play, hoping someone would come open downfield, but they never did.
And he missed it. It's no good. And this will remain a scoreless game.
And that one, my goodness, that was almost too easy.
Yeah, you're not going to have too many attempts shorter than that one. And I don't think this was blocked. That's about as bad a miss as you can have.
The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. Well, they were intercepted the first time they had the football, but now they get it back, and it's still 0-0.
And because of that, you know what the thought process is? Interception. What interception? It didn't really happen because they gave up no points. So go back on the attack. Go back and run the offense you believe will be successful. Find your playmakers and give them the football.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. The first carry now, this is Johnson. And just no chance of turning the corner. He can only get back to the line of scrimmage. Second and 10 coming up. Looked like he was trying to bounce it outside, but no success.
Yeah, sometimes you got to just figure out where you're going to go, and sometimes you just have to take it to another spot. In trying to get it outside, the defensive pursuit was there and just ran him down.
And his throw's going to be incomplete.
They've given him some different looks here defensively in the early going. He's only hit two of his first five passes. With a big third down coming up, he's hoping he's got a play dialed up that can take advantage of whatever the defense throws at him.
They come up to the line now facing a third and 10 after the incompletion. Here's Lance to throw it. And that's going to be incomplete. The contact there enough to jar that ball free, and it brings up fourth down.
Two drives won't tell the story of this game, but you absolutely have to like how this defense has played thus far. They have yet to allow this offense to get untracked in this one.
The offense staying out there. They look prepared to go here on fourth and 10. And they'll go for it. Lance. Dancing, and he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. What a real head scratcher there. And it'll be a turnover on downs. And this should be the final play before the quarter ends. It's a play fake. Now Vic. Trying to get it to Jackson, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Minka Fitzpatrick. And the Niners are going to get possession of the football as time will run out on this first quarter of play. No score after one on EA Sports. The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive. And last time they were very fortunate, this offense. They went for it on fourth, turned it over in their own territory, but the other guys held up. They didn't give up any points.
So how about the guy with the number one headset on the sidelines, the head coach? That was planned going into it, not necessarily to not get the first down or to have the defense have to hold up.
But he trusted his defense.
Trusted his defense very much, and I think that that's how he's going to play this game. Go for it. Be aggressive, because I got the Wild Bunch backing me up over here on my own sideline.
Now we'll see what his offense can do.
Whenever we talk about the best strong safeties, one word constantly comes up, and that's instincts. Being able to diagnose run or pass and make the appropriate moves.
He crashed down hard there. He was ready for that running play. They go back to the ground, this time Mostert. And he's able to get it to the 31, and that's enough for the first.
That's quite a spot there for his first carry of the game, but obviously they had plenty of faith in him, didn't they?
No question about it. And here, why not go with the fresh legs? Able to push forward, pick up that first. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Here's Lance. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
This defense has been very disruptive early on as they force another one to go awry.
Seems to be front and the back end. Pass rush, they've been able to get home, and they're taking the ball away in coverage as well.
I love how you put it together. The front and back working in sync, only way to play good defense.
To throw on second and 10, Lance. An unlucky number here, a loss of 13 on the play. And they're going to face an uphill battle here on third and long. Lance going to throw. This will be caught. It's Samuel. They get a big amount back, 18 yards, but they'll still look at a fourth down now. 2 minutes on the clock in what's been a scoreless first half. Lance and company going on fourth down. And that is knocked away in the middle of the field and incomplete. Boy, a curious decision to go for it doesn't pan out. And the Eagles are going to take over in great field position. Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. That's going to be caught by Pitts. And they're going to be set up down around the 15-yard line.
He's a rookie, and you don't want to get hung up on the word potential. But when you see him make catches like that, you keep thinking to yourself, he's good now. He's got a chance to be great with plenty of work.
And he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down.
On any running play that's called, they're always hoping that it's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice gain like that, you're able to do so many things anyway. You can come back and run essentially the same play again, continue to move the ball on the ground, or you can decide to throw the ball now because usually you have the defense back on its heels.
Well, nearly another interception there. That would have been 2 drives in a row with a pick.
He's got to start taking care of the ball way better than what we're seeing.
Interestingly, that throw was probably worse than the one he threw the interception on last drive, but fell incomplete. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. Touchdown! A.J. Brown from 10 yards out as his guys are first onto the scoreboard here this afternoon. PAT, and that makes the score 7-0. So after the touchdown, here's Blankenship kicking off. Fielded just outside the goal line. And taken down just past the 20 at about the 21-yard line. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. And last time out, went for it on fourth down, turned it over, gave him great field position, turned into 6 points, so they've got to recover here, Charles.
It's amazing what one decision can do in the chain of events, right? The decision to go for it on fourth down.
Caused all of that.
It caused every bit of it, but it showed confidence. Hey, I've got confidence in you guys. Go pick it up for them. Didn't happen. Also showed confidence in the defense. They didn't pick up their end of the bargain. So now they've got to come back out and start over and rebuild that confidence.
Looking to throw again on second down. Lance. Into double coverage and it's intercepted. Picked off by Eric Rowe. And the return here is stopped at the 35-yard line. Second interception for him now here in this first half. And you got to think he's a rookie, Charles. How much does confidence?
Never had no money, but me. I've been out here trying to get.